Thank you, Sani. What an awesome speech. You liked it all?
Yes.
Awesome. Good job, Sani. We are really proud of you. And thank you for those kind words. And by the way, I'm going to try something new tonight, okay? New recipe. You're all welcome for that. And I'm pretty sure you're all enjoying this Saturday morning with us. And thank you for coming and giving your, us your Saturday morning. And let me ask you all a question. Who likes Santa Banta? Or I would rather say, who don't like Santa Banta, right? So once a friend asked Santa, "Hey Santa, where did you born?" "Oh, India." He was very proud. And, "Oh, okay, which part?" "Which part?" "Oi, the whole body was born in India, man, including my brain." So talking about India, today I'm going to tell you a story about a girl from India named Kamal. And I will be talking about her childhood, her qualities, and how she inspired everyone. So Kamal was born in India, in Nagpur from Maharashtra, on July 6, 1905. She was very fortunate. She was born in a culturally rich family who adored her and always supported her. She always liked to do all the rituals in the family. She used to go to temple with her grandma. She used to love to sing bhajans and listen to the stories from her grandma and her parents. And she always liked to learn. She wanted to go to school. So her father put her in a mission school, because there were no school available at that time for girls in Nagpur or even in Maharashtra. In mission school, they used to sing prayer. Everyone does that, right? And there was a simple rule for that. When you're singing a prayer, you close your eyes. Now, this was a very simple thing for us, but curious Kamal wanted to see if her teacher is also following the same rule. So one day, Kamal opened her eyes, and guess what happened? She got yelled at because teacher saw her that she was opening her eyes during the prayer. Kamal was a brave girl, and she had specific thoughts in her mind. She always thought, if a person is saying something, he or she should act on that exactly same. When growing up, Kamal had more brothers than sisters, so obviously she used to play with boys all the time, and she was like a tomboy. But when it was a time for her marriage, and you might think it might be 20 years old or 25 years, no, it's not even 30 years old, it was just 9 or 10 years old. In old times, in India, girls used to get married at age of just 9 or 10 years. At that time, she told her father very clearly, "Okay, father, I'm going to marry a man who will not take dowry from my father." Very clear. It's very simple for us, right? But think about it. It was early 1900s. At that time, girls were not even allowed to come out in the living room and talk to men. They had no their own opinions. And that time, Kamal told that to her father. She eventually got married with a lawyer, Purushottam Rao. And after marriage, she became Mrs. Lakshmi Bai Purushottam Rao Kerkar. Some of you might know this name. So Lakshmi Bai Purushottam Rao had two girls from his first marriage, and he was a widower. Lakshmi Bai really took good care of these new daughters. They also wanted to learn, wanted to go to school. But of course, there was no school available in Wardha as well. But with lots of efforts, Lakshmi Bai started first girls' school in Wardha. Lakshmi Bai was born with a spirit of patriotism, a social awareness, sacrifice, service. She was a born leader. She was well aware of the things happening around her, especially women. And she always wanted to do something. She used to go to the rallies, that her patriotic rallies with freedom fighters. We call it as a Prabhat Feri. She used to go to Sevagram to serve people. She also used to go and listen to the different speeches of great leaders. So once, she went to listen to Gandhiji. Gandhiji said, "All Mahilas should become Sita." Immediately, Lakshmi Bai stood up and asked, "So don't you think all the men should be Rama too?" Gandhiji laughed, smiled, and he said, "If the Mahila becomes Sita, then Ram will automatically happen. Each Mahila has a great power inside her." And Lakshmi Bai got really inspired with this. And she decided to do something for women and she started working. Lakshmi Bai had great intention to do something for women. And she started working, but unfortunately in 1932 she lost her husband. But it didn't stop her. She kept on working. And at the same time of period, she was fortunate enough to come across with an amazing personality. Guess who? Dr. Baliram Helgeoy. Amazing Dr. Ji started RSS in 1925 in Nagpur. And her sons, Lakshmibai's sons, he started going to RSS. He joined that organization. And she realized an amazing change in them in a positive way. She met Dr. Ji. And with lots of effort and Dr. Ji's help, she started similar organization for women in 1936 named Rashtriya Sevika Samiti, a national organization for women. There were very specific goals of this organization for women: Matrutva, Kartrutva and Netrutva. Let me explain. The goal was women should become independent. They should be able to take their own decisions. They should be skilled. They should be very strong mentally and physically both, and also they should be serving for the society. So woman will take care of herself and she will not care for the family. That was never a goal of Samiti. Family is always her first priority. But think about this. If woman has all those skills, then definitely when she is teaching, those skills will reflect in her teaching, and definitely it will reflect in the society. Lakshmi Bai was very hardworking. She was punctual, she was neat, and she was loving too. She was well known as the name of Mausiji, like auntie, and she was loved by everyone, and she used to love everyone. All the mahilas in the samiti, they used to think Mausiji loves her most than everyone else. She was like a mother to all. When I start talking about Mausiji, I cannot stop. Even next 2 hours won't be enough for me. But don't worry. Today, with just one more incident, I will stop. It was 1948. It was time for India of independence, happy time. But also, it was a time for partition. There were a lot of fights going on. It was not a good time for India. And at the same time, Lakshmi Bai got a letter from a Sevika from Lahore saying, "We want to raise a flag on 15th August, but we are scared. We don't know what to do." Now in this situation, Lakshmi Bai might have sent her letter back, giving some good advice or giving some moral support. But that was not her nature. Lakshmi Bai took one Sevika with her and got on a plane going to Lahore. There were only two mahilas on that plane. But without any hesitation, she went to Lahore, they raised the flag, and that was Mausiji. She inspired me every time. She inspired me to become a good human being. She inspires me to do some seva, do some service for the society. And I hope if some of you get inspired with this story, that will serve my purpose. Thank you. And now it's my great pleasure to introduce our next speaker, Shubhangi Ji Ahir. Shubhangi Ji is a computer professional. She is a computer engineer and she works at Allegis Technology. She lives in Burlington with her family, her daughter, Gati, husband and her mom. And what can I say about her? A friend in need is a friend indeed. That's Shubhangi Ji. So you might have the same experience like me. And one more sweet thing about her, she has got pretty good sweet tooth. And I'm pretty sure you will enjoy her speak. So, Shubha.